What's up, guys? It's Eric, and this video here is all about panic attack and anxiety attacks while driving. A lot of us do get anxiety attacks and panic attacks while driving, and there are a couple different hacks out there that can help you through these. It's very commonplace for people to have driving anxiety. When I first got sober, I had a lot of anxiety attacks and a lot of anxiety while driving because, well, I was a recovering addict and I drank and drove a lot. Not something I'm extremely proud of, but something that I did find some hacks that worked for. Again, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a counselor, I'm not a therapist. My name is Eric. I am diagnosed with ADHD, PTSD, GAD, and MDD. I lost a wife and a father to suicide, and I'm a recovering cocaine alcoholic addict. If you haven't hit the like and subscribe button, hit that like and subscribe button. So let's go over anxiety attacks and panic attacks while driving. They're going to happen one of two places. You're probably going to be on the freeway or you're going to be on the back roads. When an anxiety attack or panic attack hits, the panic attack is going to be a lot more intense. The anxiety attack will not be as intense. But both of them, you want to probably do grounding about the same way. At least that's what I did. And again, not a doctor, not a counselor, not a therapist. If you're on the back roads, find a safe place to pull over. Find a safe place to pull over your vehicle so that you are off the road. If you're on the freeway, though, and you have an anxiety attack or panic attack kick in, do not get off the freeway unless you can and you're in the furthest right lane. If you're in the middle lane or you're in the left lane and you're going down the freeway and you start to have a panic attack or anxiety attack, the biggest thing is you don't want to add or increase to that of trying to figure out how to get over to get off of the freeway. It will only increase and amplify everything. Instead, you want to stay in the same lane you're in and not add to it. A big thing, don't add to it. A lot of times we'll get even worse because we're trying to merge over and we start screaming because people are blowing past us. Don't. Just stay in the same lane. And one of the easier things to do even is to let your foot off the gas a little bit, maybe decrease your speed some. Also, have a toolkit in your car. And what I mean by that is have things in your car to help distract you. In my truck, these are things actually that I have pulled out right now that are in my truck. I have Listerine cubes. I have Hull's cough drops, I have warheads, and I also have even a coin. Now, the reason that I have these in here is when I'm driving and I start to have anxiety and I can feel the anxiety attack starting to come on, I will all of a sudden start grounding myself. I'll take one of the Listerine cubes, put it in my mouth so that I can feel myself and feel my senses in my mouth instead of in my thoughts, instead of worrying about the cars and everything around me. Start using your senses because that's what grounding is all about. Another thing to do is make sure that these are on you at all times in your car so that they do hit, you don't also panic or increase that anxiety because you can't find them. Make them easy to get to, but have things that stimulate your senses. Warheads, sour, anything sour, bitter, hot, anything that will massively direct your attention to your mouth and out of your thoughts while you're driving. You're always going to be paying attention while you're driving, but the worst part is when we disassociate, we get trapped back into our head. Another thing that I always keep with me are things to fidget with. Coins, things that I can physically be driving and I can now have, okay, it's okay, I'm using my sense of touch now. And it helps calm me down because a lot of it, I don't do breathing exercises very well because it will help me start to hyperventilate. So when I'm flipping things is when I get my breathing down as I flip. And that's the whole reason I'm a big fan of coins, is this is what I match my breathing up with as it's going through my hand, and it will help calm and relax some. Another thing to do is while you're driving, start to roll down the windows, get the fresh air in, get the different sounds in. It starts to simulate your senses of taste going right down your mouth. Now this is going to add to it. It will stimulate your hearing. Also smells, because you're now going to start being very aware of the area that you're in and your attention will start to be directed differently of, oh, well, what's that? What's that? The cold air on your face helps. Warm air on your face helps because it helps shift your body temperature because you're feeling your heart like you're having a heart attack. You feel it moving into your throat. So changing your temperature, turning up the AC or lowering down the AC, turning on the heat, anything you can do to change the temperature of your surrounding. Another thing is if you have heated seats, turn on your heated seats. If you have air-conditioned seats, turn on your air-conditioned seats. Do something to start changing your body temperature to keep you here into the present so that we don't disassociate fully and get trapped up into our thoughts. Another thing even, turn on the radio, get the radio up, get the music going. A lot of times music is soothing to us. It can add to it, but typically music will help soothe you some. These are things that are going to help you start to work through this panic attack and this anxiety attack. And the biggest of all is to get that breathing going. Because when we do have anxiety attacks and panic attacks, what adds to it a lot is we're gasping for air because I can't breathe. And it only increases our fear and our anxiety. So using your senses, use as many as you can. Heated seats, window down, stuff in your mouth. That's all going to help you. And the big one is to still use the sense of touch, because you're going to find something out there that ends up working for you, that gets your senses going, that allows you to take control back over your body. Because an anxiety attack and a panic attack, you can fight through them and you can ground yourself through them. Even if you have to have salt on you, put salt on your mouth. That one will shock you really well. Find what works for you though, and don't give up. Because you got to remember, a lot of people do have anxiety when driving. A lot of people do have panic attacks and anxiety attacks while driving. So you're not the only one. And when these do hit, you can make it through it. And each accomplishment that you have, celebrate that victory, because it's a series of victories that build up that remind us that we can do this and we can push through it. Use what you have and the tools around you. But a big one, make sure that you have an anxiety kit in your car, especially if you have panic disorder, if you have general anxiety disorder, things that are always constantly around you to be able to help you. And make sure that you have them for specific locations too, that you have a set of items for your vehicle that doesn't leave your vehicle. Because if it does leave your vehicle, the one thing that is worse is it can have that reverse effect, that we're looking for stuff that we thought we had and we don't have it, that, oh my God, now it even gets worse. So make sure that you're always prepared, especially if you're taking a long trip. I believe in you. I mean, you made it this far and that you can fight through these, and it's finding what works for you. If it's rolling down all the windows, one of the nice things too is once you've pulled over, or once you've gotten through it, or if you gotten to that point that it's too much, but we've fought through it and we're finally off the road, but it's still there and it's still lingering, don't be afraid to call somebody. And call, you know, a good friend, a family member, and let them know what's going on. Even send them your location if you need to, if you need them to come get you and to come get help. Because the worst thing is now all of a sudden that we've had this anxiety attack, we've had this panic attack, we're over on the side of the road, we're beating ourselves up over in our head, and we're having no positive reinforcement come in. Get some of that positive reinforcement and get that through a friend or through a family member, somebody that you can reach out to and talk to and say, hey, I just had a massive panic attack. I had a massive anxiety attack. Here's what I'm feeling. So that we can start to own those emotions. You get that positive reinforcement and then you can go back at it. You're a BAMF. You're a badass motherfucker. You've made it through 100% of your worst days to make it through two today. And you got this. Down below in the description are all my links to all my different social medias. I have links to the mental health Discord communities. It's free peer-to-peer support. I'm trying to bridge the gap between a crisis hotline and therapy, of all the tools, experiences, and resources that it can share. I even have links below to things on Amazon that I use, like fidget cubes, fidget spinners, things that help me with calming my anxiety. I even have a link down below to BetterHelp. Again, it's therapy. If you've never tried therapy before, it's trial and error to find the right therapist for you and the right type of therapy for you. And it's about never giving up. So if you're struggling out there, never give up, because you have made it this far. You've made it to today. So keep pushing forward, and it does get better, and it's baby steps. It's celebrating those small victories. Next time that you have an anxiety attack or panic attack in the car, fight through this together with me and start celebrating that victory that yes, you can do it. And it becomes easier and it becomes easier and it becomes easier. And I believe in you. You've made it to today. And together we got this. So hit that like and subscribe button, comment down below. I'd love to know your thoughts or what else you use when you have anxiety attacks or panic attacks in the car that have helped you, because that's what it's about. The more that we share, the more experiences that we share, the better we are together. You got this. Like and subscribe. Let's do this.